Namaskaram. I am Manda Sudha Rani, a musician from Visakhapatnam, Andhra Pradesh. I happily belong to the lineage of Dwaram tradition of Vijayanagaram. As my guru, Sangīta Kala Sagara, Sri Ivaturu Vijayeshwarrao Garu, is a direct disciple of violin maestro Sri Dwaram Narasingarao Naidu Garu. Since my childhood, I have had the great pleasure of listening to Balamuralikrishna sir's music. Be it the gramophone record of Ramadasa Kritis, the Hamsa Gita movie, the Bhakta Prahlada songs, the live concerts in Vivekananda Hall in Visakhapatnam, and especially his live concerts in Chennai during December season, which we used to attend regularly, and the most valuable cassette recordings of Sangeeta. Particularly, I remember his concert in the year 1978, when he received the Sangīta Sudhā Nidhi Award from Madras Music Academy. In that, he presented some masterpieces like Neerajakshi Kamakshi, the Muthuswami Dikshitar Kirti in the Raga Hindola, Bhavame Mahabhagyamura, his own composition in the Raga Kapi, the Ragam Tanam Pallavi in the Raga Kalyani in Panchamukhi Talam, and finally the Priya Raga and Gati Malika Tillana, and held the audience just spellbound. His live concerts are an experience by themselves. For a common man, it's a treat to the ears. For a learner, it's a lesson which is inspiring and full of joy. And for a seasoned rasika, it's an aesthetic experience. As a student of music, I am particularly fascinated by his techniques of swarakalpana and pronunciation. Even without music, just the words of a language would sound most beautiful in his voice. He gave utmost respect to the pronunciation of words of any language he sang. My guru, Sri Ivaturu Vijayeshwarrao Garu, also had great reverence towards Sri Balamuralikrishna Garu. And he gave me so many insights about Balamurali sir's musical genius and his contribution through All India Radio, Vijayawada. Coming to the present, Sri Srinivasamurthy Garu has taken up the responsibility of sharing the treasure of Sri Balamuralikrishna's music through his channel in YouTube. For this, he designed a project in a unique way by adding an introduction by an artist discussing the highlights of the given track so as to enhance the listening experience of the enthusiastic listeners. I sincerely thank him for giving me such a wonderful opportunity to say a few words in my humble limitations about the great maestro. In this particular context, we are going to discuss Tódi in different perspectives contributed by Sri Balamuralikrishna with respect to the Kriti Sudhānidhé, his own composition in Telugu, set in medium pace and set to a cycle of 8 beats, that is Aditalam. In this track, he is accompanied on violin by Sri M.S. Gopalakrishnan Garu and on the mridangam by Sri T.V. Gopalakrishnan Garu. Before going into the perspectives of Tódi Ragam, let us know how the concept of Raga evolved in Carnatic style. A Raga can be defined as a set of swaras that are rendered in a particular order using some specific embellishments. Here, the embellishments, which are called gamakas in the Carnatic context, are very vital in defining the identity of a Raga. They are like the spice used in the food to give it a distinct taste. So the final swarupa of a raga is determined by the way how these embellishments are used with the help of presentation skills of the artist. Carnatic music is rich with the innumerable ragas, which are melodic molds that are distinct from each other on subtle aspects like a small fine embellishment, the order of the notes in a given sanchara, the number of notes present in ascending or descending order, etc. So, to preserve the character and identity of a raga, some rules were framed rigidly, and that rigidity definitely helped to present and preserve the molds over the centuries, and it became a tradition for many to follow the beaten track. But the overemphasis on certain type of embellishments, usage of similar and repetitive themes, is a threat to any creative field as it allows monotony. So Balamurali sir questioned and modified the Gamaka system by using his own filters that are based on his aesthetic judgment. Of course, his extraordinary skills also helped him in bringing out various perspectives of raga successfully. That is why his approach to tradition is an addition to the Carnatic tradition. Let us now find out how he achieved this in this recording of Sudhānidhé in the raga Tódi. Started the alapana in the most conventional Carnatic style, with sangati set in medium pace. He did not stay at one note, keeping the violinist and the audience in suspense, which he used to do occasionally in his later years, only to make them alert and attentive towards music. He tries to avoid the excessively used sangati at Gandharam in Tódi, which starts from Chatusatrishamam, like ga instead he used the small gamakas in its own place, ga 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 ma ba ma ga 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 re ta da re 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 re. Only two oscillations he gives and proceeds further. In the Tarasthayi also, he avoids that sangati and hits the Gandharam straight. In 1950s and 60s, the whole Carnatic music field was greatly influenced by Rajaratnam Pillai's Nadaswaram style. Looks like Balamurali sir was also not an exception. Let us see how it will be. Sangatis, we find his presentation is close to that of Nadaswaram style in the texture of sangatis, intensity in presentation. Later on, his style seems to have mellowed down, becoming more smooth, gentle and meditative. Graha Bhedam is an interesting and challenging aspect of music. It is equivalent to the concept of tonic shift in Western music. Graha means starting point, Bhedam means change or shift from one point to another. We can explain Graha Bhedam in terms of geometry also. Please take a square drawn on the board. Imagine a diagonal in that square. Now you will see it not as a square, but as a combination of two right angle triangles in opposite directions. So we are able to find a hidden shape in a given shape. That diagonal helped us in changing our perspective in looking at the figure. Similarly, there is a raga hidden in another raga, which can be found out with the Graha Bhedam technique. It's a known fact that there are 12 notes in an octave. The Graha Bhedam concept is based on the beautiful phenomena that all the 12 notes of an octave are arranged in unequal distances among themselves. So let us see the Graha Bhedam possibilities in the raga Tódi. Sarigama padanisa sanidavamagarisa. Now let us start with Graha Bhedam at Rishabham in the raga Tódi. Let us start with the small phrase. Rigamapada. Now, if we shift our perspective of Adhara Shajyam from Sa to Ri, which means consider Rishabham as Shajyam. Rigamapada Ri Sa Sarigamapa. It sounds like Purvangam of Kalyani. Rigamapada Dapamagari. Sarigamapapamagarisa. This happens because the distance between Sudharishabham and Sadharana Gandharam, Riga in Tódi, the distance is same as the distance between Shajyam and Chatusudharishabham, Sari Riga. Now let us extend this to full scale. Rigamapadanisarisanidapamagarisa. This is how the raga Kalyani is obtained by doing Graha Bhedam at Rishabham in raga Tódi. The most prominent ragas of our music, Shankarabharanam, Kharaharapriya, Tódi, Kalyani, Harikamboji and Natabhairavi, are arranged in tandem like the colors of Vibhyar based on this Graha Bhedam concept. Even most prominent pentatonic scales like Mohana, Madhyamavati, Hindola, Sudhasaveri and Sudhadanyasiala also obtained by Graha Bhedam in all these ragas. Like Riga Madani Ri, by omitting the Shajya and Panchamam, Riga Madani Ri Ri Nidamagari. We get Sariga Padasa Sadapagari Sa Mohanam in Raga Tódi. Balamurli sir had contributed a lot in this aspect. By doing Graha Bhedam with utmost ease and aesthetic balance, and he brings out the raga bhavam most beautifully. He sang some RTPs also in the set of ragas like Abhogi and Valaji, Hamsadhvani and Nagaswaravali. In this space, the later raga is obtained by doing Graha Bhedam in the former raga. For example, Sarigamadasa Sadamagarisa. That is Abhogi. If you do Graha Bhedam from Madhyamam, Mada Sarigama Magari Sadama Sagapadani Sa Sanidapagasa. That is Valaji. In this genre, the ultimate is his Dhai Raga Mala Tillana in the Raga Kalyani, which is based on this concept. Now, let us find out how he showed his mastery on this aspect in this track. Does it looks like he is going to do graha bhedam at daivatam. Generally we will assume that da da ni sa ni da in todi, if we do graha bhedam at daivatam, we should get shankaravarnam. Da da ni sa ri sa ni da sa ri ga ma ga ri sa da pa ma pa da sa ni da ni sa. But he is singing some sangeetis like that. Na 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 na. Now, if daivatam is a shadyam, sa ni da pa ma ma pa da pa. No, we cannot shape panchamam like that. So, that daivatam is not sa in his view. He made it as a panchamam. Da pa ma ga re sa sa ri ga re da ma pa. So, not going in a usual way by making daivatam a shadyam, he made it a panchamam. So, that is the stroke of genius, that he can touch any part of the gamut and bring out beauty from there. That is why his music is a miracle in melody. Coming to the other aspects in the recording, Balamuralikrishna sir totally stuck to the traditional way of ragalapana, which remained in the medium tempo throughout. The voice is smooth, even, full of joy, confidence, and it is smiling. It is difficult to anticipate him. The way he combines sangatis in three octaves with smooth and long jumps is a treat to the audience, yet a challenge to the accompaniment. But such a task was performed so gracefully and successfully by Sri M.S. Gopalakrishnan, the violin maestro. While accompanying, MSG follows like a shadow and echoes the vocal sangatis in no time. During his turn, he adds his own perspective of the raga to the vocalist's version. We are really fortunate to see great masters coming together on one stage and do the magic of the music. The Kriti Sudhānidhé is in Manipravala style. That means multilingual. The Pallavi and Anupallavi are in Sanskrit and the Charanam is in Telugu. It is his own composition. It has beautiful Swaraksharas. It starts like Sudhānidhé in Pallavi. Sadanisa. Sudhānidhé in Sahityam. Sadanisa in Swaram. And also in Charanam, Sariga Manasu Nilpi. Sariga is the Swaram, Sariga, that is the Swaram. And in Sahityam, Sariga means properly. The mood of the song does not have any baggages, and he just extols the deity with an enthusiastic mind. The Naraval is taken up at the Charanam, which is full of letters. It is like this. Sariga manasu nilpi palimpumana varamulusagi broche swami vata. Because this is full of letters, it is very difficult to show variations in Naraval. But he does it like a child's play. He breaks the words conveniently and at proper places to get some space to fill it with a sangati whenever he feels like. For example, Sariga manasu nilpi palimpumana, and also manasu nilpi palimpumana, varamulosagi broche swami vata. You can leave the vata also. Varamulosagi broche swami also, you can stop like that. So you have a space there and you can use it to bring a sangati there. His swarakalpana is full of simple mathematics combined with melody, dhatu swarams like sari, saga, sama, sapa, sada, sani, sasa. That kind of dhatu swarams he used extensively. Unexpected twists which look mysteriously simple. Particularly, it is always difficult to comprehend his takeoff in Swarakalpana. It takes another great maestro to anticipate him, and that is how Sri C.V. Gopalakrishnan Garu accompanied Balamuralikrishna sir, not only in this recording but in number of recordings. P.V.G. sir's accompaniment matches with Balamuralikrishna sir's music in depth and heights and in maths and melody. Balamuralikrishna sir is quite well known for his spontaneity and lively presence on the stage. He can turn even noise disturbance into musical elegance. For example, in this track, he'll be singing like this. Then all of a sudden, there is an intruding noise. Like that. It is the sound of a train passing by. Then he converts that also into his music. He immediately finds out that it is coinciding with the Shuddha Daivatam in higher octave. Da! Then he imitates it in his own voice and pitch. Na, da, na, and again proceeds in his own flow without any hitch. That is the spontaneity of such a great artist. So, let us proceed towards listening to Balamuralikrishna's music, which is sonorous to the ears, soothing to the heart, and stimulating to the intellect. We can enjoy the music even without knowing the intricacies because of the dimension called apata madhuramu. That means you can just let yourself flow with the currents of melody and rhythm and have the blissful experience of music. But by analyzing the music, we are exploring another dimension called alochanamritam, the intellectual pleasure derived by learning something in a scientific way. So, classical music is a combination of both the dimensions, apata madhuramu and alochanamritamu. The words madhuramu and amritamu indicating pleasure being the goal. So, classical music will stay forever because it's an art form which has a scientific basis, and the music of great masters like Balamuralikrishna sir is a living example of what real classical music is. Namaskaram.